The Philippines was the lone colony of the Spanish Empire in Asia for 333 years, and naturally,
Spanish influences are deeply ingrained into the Filipino consciousness and heritage. In 1565, 44 years after Ferdinand Magellan arrived in what we call now the Philippines, the archipelago became the hub for the Manila-Acapulco galleon trade. This became a conduit for the massive exchange of culture, goods, and ideas between East Asia, Mexico, other Latin American countries, Spain, and the Philippines.
Besides religion, language, arts, music, literature, social customs, and values, Spain also impacted our gastronomy, as it introduced ingredients and techniques both from Spain and the New World.
Just like any colonization, the Philippines fought for independence from Spain. Despite that, in today's context, the two countries have maintained strong ties, giving value to their shared history, values, and traditions. Filipino food is a conduit to its history. Today, we're taking a look at famous rice dishes that could tell us a bit more about how flavors blend and evolve. The Spanish arroz al caldoso and paella have lots in common with our bringe, or arroz a la valenciana. And I'm on a mission to dig a little deeper into the past so that I can better understand where Filipino food is headed. This is Crossing Borders.
Known for his whimsical and inventive approach to Spanish cuisine, González has received critical acclaim for his culinary creations, making Galleria Baichele one of the most high-profile restaurants in Asia.
Well, Galleria is a fine dining restaurant. What is focused in the inspiration is the Philippines. We don't necessarily sometimes said we cook Filipino cuisine, but of course, because we are inspired in the Philippines, in the region, in the ingredients, in the people, in the farmers, sometimes also in the flavors, and sometimes also in Filipino cuisine. So sometimes in the journey, because it's a tasting menu, it's a journey. So Galleria is a terroir cuisine inspired in the Philippines.
His popularity can also be attributed to the ability to craft dishes that flaunt the diversity of Spanish cuisine, yet that taps into local culture and ingredients. More recently, he started gravitating towards the sensory aspect of Filipino cuisine. For the chef, his interest in the cuisine stems from his natural inquisitiveness about indigenous cultures and people. He has opened a few other places since. Today, we are at his brand new restaurant, where he cooks dishes from his hometown.
So Cantabria is my homeland, is where I grew up. It's one region in the north of Spain. So in terms of ingredients, we are in the Atlantic between Galicia and France, and it's considered one of the best seafood in the world. So this is where I feel my family recipes, the food I grew up with, and a region that have beautiful ingredients and beautiful story to tell, that I think is also coming from there, my responsibility to put it in the map.
Oof, okay, I am extremely late. Nakakahiya talaga kay Erwan and kay Chele, because I'm not based here in the Philippines anymore, and I went to the wrong restaurant. I didn't know that Chele has a new restaurant here, and I hope I make it on time.
Chele, first of all, I'm so sorry I'm late.
It's okay. Let's have a good lunch, you know, and then let's make, you know, our day
better.
And wrong.
And congratulations on the new space.
Thank you very much. Yes.
But this is not going to be your typical paella, right?
No. Not because in the north of Spain, we don't cook paella. Uh-huh. It, that is more from the Mediterranean, Valencia and Alicante. Mm-hmm. It's called dry rice. What we use in the north of Spain is wet rice.
Because of it's colder?
It's colder. It's more like a stew. It's uh-huh. something, you know, more comfort uh-huh. at some point. One of the most iconic dishes in the north of Spain is a calamar en su tinta. That is black ink stew. And actually, it's very, very, very similar to the squid adobo or adobo de pusit.
Okay.
So since always when I go to Sarsa, I always order adobo pusit because for me, your recipe is one of the best in Manila.
Thank you.
I wanted to do something that connect with that and also represents my region. First step, of course, olive oil. And then we are going to go...
Wow, that with... much onions, huh?
Ah, yes, because the onion will reduce and become very little after we caramelize. So this is the process that it will take a little bit longer because it needs time, you know, to slowly cook and poach and bring the natural sugar out. The funny part about this is one of the only few Spanish dishes that it comes with a bowl of rice on the side, okay? There is a strong connection between the... that it could have, you know, some interaction with Filipino, no? You know, over the years, checking, you know, the gastronomy in the Philippines, it's interesting, but I think some dishes evolve or change in Spain, and they still remain how it used to be 400 years ago in the Philippines. So we still can learn and can go back in the past to see, you know, how it was Spanish cuisine 400 years ago.
No? So is this a dish where you were saying that everyone... would look forward to this dish? Is it like a for a special occasion? Like
I will say in the old times it was for a special occasion because it takes time. It takes like 2 to 3 hours to cook this.
Just like say with bringhe, pampanga, you know, they serve that dish when there's a festival, and so I guess those are the little influences that we, you know, get from each other.
So the squid in the top is the one that is just punchier. So you can see it's, you know, medium rare, but it's very tender. It will keep it tender. And then the scallop is just punchier as well. And then the rice, you know, is a mix of, you know, yeah, at some point you will call it maybe arroz caldo because it's arroz caldoso. So it's a little bit more like stew, creamy, wet rice. So let me serve you. Let me
Beautiful.
Take you a... So it still feels like a paella, a little bit more wet.
Such an honor.
Thank you very much.
The rice.
This flavor, we have a lot of flavor. Even you know, no need to put alioli or anything. Just try the rice itself.
It's like you can taste every grain coated with a squid ink. It's very comforting, but at the same time, complex. When I said complex, it's because it feels like there's so many things going on, but at the same time, simple.
Yes, yes, yes.
This is amazing. So, how would you describe Filipino cuisine?
It's complex because for me, I have the opportunity to really travel and meet a lot of indigenous communities, ancestral cooking, where that doesn't have any Spanish, Chinese, or any other influence. It's just the pure nature of Filipino cuisine, more than the indigenous side. And something that always come up in every single community is always the sour agent. Depends on the part of the Philippines, of the community, it will be something, can be a herb, can be a vegetable, can be, it's just called sour agent. So that particular sour soup that is always part of all of the different communities made me realize understand that this acidity in the Filipino food is something unique that I haven't seen anywhere else in the world. And then, you know, of course, you know, the complexity goes more when you have the Spanish influence, you have the Chinese influence, and become what is today a Filipino cuisine, which is also a lot of American influence.
Now that we know more about the Spanish cuisine, it's time to head to Pampanga, one of the gastronomy centers in the Philippines, to learn more about their famous bringhe.
Thank you. Naman. Happy to have seen Chele. I'm happy na he's happy, he's busy, happy daddy. Ang saya lang talaga yung exchange of knowledge, friendship from two cultures, you know, Spanish, Filipino, united through food. And just inspiring. Pero the rice journey continues. We are off to Pampanga. We're gonna go see the Cloud Tayag, learn from him, get inspiration from him. Pero bago tayo pumunta sa kanya, magpaalam muna ako sa asawa ko, kuha ng gamit, kasi after ng Cloud Tayag cooking session, magluluto kami.
In some provinces around the country, you might be served bringhe or biringhi. It is the perfect dish to illustrate a localized version of the Spanish paella. The ingredients vary, but you'll find coconut milk here instead of fish broth, sticky rice instead of bomba, turmeric instead of saffron, and the list goes on. Instead of a flat pan, we usually use a playo. In the province of Pampanga, Cloud Tayag, an acclaimed Filipino chef, artist, restaurateur, and writer, makes one of the best ones. His recipes also prove that traditional food keeps evolving and changing.
We go way back, and then minsan namin nakikita net, nung totoy na totoy pa lang ako, nandun na si Cloud.
Fresh from Australia, diba?
Oh, fresh from Australia and fresh from Bacolod to transitioning to Manila. And of course, I would always read about Cloud. And then diba, you walked in our door one afternoon.
Uh-huh.
I was in the kitchen, and I'm like, oh my God, is that Cloud Tayag?
Kilala mo na ako.
Oh, naman. Sino ba hindi kilala? Who doesn't know you? I'm like, oh my God. And then, ano kayo orderin nito? And then yun, nag-order ka ng pancit molo.
Oh.
Tapos sinabi mo, no offense sa mga taga Iloilo ah. Alam ko, masarap naman talaga yung pancit molo nyo dun. Pero at that time, sabi mo, I remember this was more than 10 years ago, I just came from Iloilo, but your pancit molo is really good.
Yeah, kasi in a way, yung sa kanya, yung interpretation, I think this is what Philippine cuisine is all about. I will elaborate on that later. Yung ginawa niyang pancit molo, nandun nga yung molo. Sina pancit? Walang pancit. Saan yung noodle, sabi? Di nila maintindihan. The pancit is in the wrapper.
Correct.
We paid for our meal.
Yes, he did.
I don't like to use the word improve.
Or fusion.
No, not even not fusion. He combined elements. Kasi ang pancit molo, the base of the broth would be chicken broth. Minsan merong hibi, may ano. Depending on the maker, kung anong available, ganun nga yung Philippine cuisine in general. The dish conforms to the maker. Pwede mong paghalo-halo nito, ganyan-ganyan, kasi wala tayong fixed recipes.
And di ba you were going around, di ba yung linamnam na libro?
Yes.
Now, which is the Bible of every Filipino cook. Here and abroad.
Na-feature na kita doon. So, lumabas ito, 2011. It's a culinary mapping. It's not a cookbook, per se.
Right.
It's not a review book. I do not rate them.
All these Filipino chefs from around the world, this is their guide.
Oh, here. Tawag ko dyan, it's like pancit molo on steroids.
So, nung sinabi niya yun, first time ako nakatanggap ng ganyang validation. Sabi ko, oh my God. I think I'm ready.
You're ready.
I'm ready to...
What a big city.
Yeah, I'm ready to go to the city. Yung kapatid ko si Tracy, siya yung nagsabi sa akin, sabi niya, JP, you are Ilonggo. You're an Ilonggo chef. Cook Ilonggo food. And that's how it started, the pancit molo.
For me, yung regionality mo has to show, meaning where you come from.
Where you're from.
Oo. Otherwise, you're just like any Filipino restaurant.
Exactly.
Because I was looking for local.
And sa menu namin, na example, ganito kalaki yung menu namin. Ganito lang kaliit
corner.
Yung Ilonggo corner.
Parang by the way.
Tapos, pinili niya pa yung pancit molo. Ngayon, baliktad na ang buhay ko. Ngayon, all out Filipino na ako. Dahil doon nagsimula.
Because of that one dish.
Because of that visit. I'm like...
Ako naman ang iiyak ngayon.
Parang, hindi, promise right
to
God. Parang, ito pala ang purpose ko. Do you know that every time I do a pop-up, especially in Dubai, I have this as a in my bookshelf, in my pop-up. So I guess my point is, you know, kahit saan ka man sa mundo or ano na na-achieve mo, whatever, I think you still have to go back to basics. You still have to go back to where you started because it resets
That's
you.
That's your roots. Yes, your foundation.
It realigns started, you. Yeah. And it inspires you. In the height of the pandemic, a hotel group invited us to do a pop-up. Grabe, nagulat kami. Pag 3-day pop-up, every day may 50 wait list.
Really?
Yeah.
And these are non-Filipinos?
Filipinos.
They
missed Filipino
home
food
cooking na,
so
talaga.
Bad.
Oh.
Grabe, and I could... Habang kumakain sila, umiiyak sila.
Talaga?
Promise. Ako pa,
that's the best
ako
rin, compliment.
Doon ako natauhan bilang kusinero. Oh. Doon nawala yung ego ko as a chef.
Oh.
Sabi ko, okay, from now on, I will not cook for my ego. I will cook for my people.
Kaya may sawsawan on the table.
Correct.
Gusto mong mas maalat, gusto mong manghang. The chili is always there as an option. I was going to show ito yung bringhi namin, no? I mean, bringhi basically is a fiesta rice dish. Very popular here in Pampanga. But over the decades, I've discovered that it's not specifically Pampanga alone. It is done in Bulacan, in Cavite, and it can come in another name called Valenciana. I saw it in Bacolod and Iloilo, in the marketplace. Being served in the karinderia. Di ba? Even in Bacolod, pag makita mo yung yellow rice na malagkit, what do you call it? Di ba? Valenciana? Exactly the same recipe, same form. So what I'm saying is like, ano kaya ito? Bakit Valenciana? It could be from the paella Valenciana, no? Pumunta ka sa Indonesia, pumunta ka sa South. Ano na lang, I mean, the Philippines, mga Marawi, yung kanilang pagana, yung kwan, there's always this yellow rice. Mm. Ang nasi kuning ng kwan, it's in a conical shape na ganon. It's a celebratory, ritualistic rice in the sense that they have to have that. Tapos nandun yung mga ulam surrounded. So kukuha ka ng yellow rice. And if you look on the Spanish side naman, it's so similar to the Spanish paella. Okay. And what is the commonality of the Spanish paella and the bringhi? It's the tutong, socara. The older people are after the burnt, I will not say burnt, but toasted, the caramelized bottom.
Mm.
Parang crispy rice.
Mm.
Papakita ko sa iyo yung magic paano ginagawa yung crispy rice na yon. When we are given, where we are introduced to new ingredients or to new cooking technique, we adapt it, we embrace it like our own and becomes ours.
Mm.
So what I'm saying is, now, with the tradition of our, like, I would say, yung interpretation.
Mm-hmm.
So there's freedom
mm-hmm.
to interpret our traditional dishes into whatever ingredients available. Taga coastal town ka, inland, or bundok. No? We have so many differences in our culinary traditions, depending on your geography. Pangalawa, on the availability, the affordability. I mean, the economic situation of the person. Restricted ka sa dietary restrictions or religious. Our cuisine is so fluid, meaning it's just the dish I am serving you depends on the maker. Kaya ito yung aking reaction dun sa ginawa ng what the DTI, Department of Trade and Industry, was trying to do 3 years ago. They made an announcement in the newspapers saying that they were going to standardize the recipe of adobo. Of course, hindi yung pwede. Nagalit yung buong mundo na Pilipino. They cannot simply do that because every household, every person would have their version of the adobo. How can you standardize a thing that's not even a dish? It's not a recipe. It's like in our hearts. Sa panlasa. Diba, going back to the what Philippine cuisine is, when I talk about a national cuisine, it's a sum total of its history.
Okay.
We are probably late bloomers in the game.
Okay.
But look where we are now. We just like bided our time.
Right.
Now's our time. Everywhere in the States now, it's the Filipino.
Right.
But a Filipino restaurant, upscale.
Right.
But now it's the Filipino thing is like there's pride in their Filipino culture, in their Filipino, and there's the Phil-Ams are so eager to learn, to discover their parents.
Yeah, like, nandyan na. And we have good guardians there. And that's why in the Middle East, palaging nane-neglect.
Nane-neglect.
Palaging lang siyang stopover. So, sabi namin, hindi kami mag-stopover. We will stay and, you know, try, well, you know, do our part. I thought that this is just gonna be a normal shoot that, you know, pero ngayon, I'm a student. Kulang na lang, may ballpen ako dito.
I wanted to show you the possibilities of this Biringhi. I will do the traditional one and then yung interpretations.
Tara.
Yeah.
I really want to learn.
So, I'll show you. Sige, let's go. Sige, let's go to the kitchen. So, dito tayo. So, this is my... Alam mo yung mga my dirty kitchen, so-called. Outdoor kitchen siya. You smell the fragrance, and then it turns translucent, then it's time.
Okay.
So, ngayon, yun ang pang-flavor mamaya sa, no? Plus the chicken broth. The Biringhi is done in 2 stages.
Okay.
We are gisa. Well, first stage pala yun. Second stage, you add the rice.
Right.
And then we cook the rice now. So wait, I will adjust the fire.
Uh-huh.
You don't want it rolling boil kasi it's like a slow cook.
Okay.
This is the malagkit.
Uh-huh.
So I'm using 1:1 ratio. Mm. 1 malagkit, 1 regular rice.
Okay.
It has been pre-soaked in water.
For
like 30 minutes.
Okay.
To 1 hour to remove all the excess starch.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So in the meantime, ito ko pang mas dilaw. So that is the turmeric, no? Tira mo, nagdilaw na yung gan. So, yung gata na yan, in the end, mag-oil. The oil will render. It gets incorporated into the rice.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So, in a way, parang suman na bibingka na ano pa rin, na may gata.
Nagigets ko na paano yung kapangpangan cuisine, paano siya naging so distinct.
Yeah.
I think because you guys respect the process.
The process.
Diba? And iniintindi nyo.
Yes, and this is slow cooking. Remember, this is a fresh rice dish.
Mm.
Parang pambongga. Tignan mo, dumidikit-dikit na, no?
Uh-huh.
The Spanish cuisine, because of the ingredients are imported and all, mahal. It did not trickle down to the masses. So, malapit na to, parang risotto na at this point, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Di ba there's a Spanish dish na...
Arroz caldoso.
Yeah.
Ng Spanish.
Spanish, na medyo mabasa, no?
Basa, yes. Okay, so yung arroz caldoso, kung tutusin, well, I think the similarity ends with the rice. I mean, that's a wet kind of rice dish, but iba yung ingredients nila eh. Number one, hindi malagkit rice.
Mm.
Wala tayong saffron. And then instead of the saffron, would be our local turmeric for coloring or the kasubha. So, yung al dente na rice na yon, that is the paella valenciana, arroz valenciana ang tawag nila, no? We're almost done.
Uh-huh.
I mean, for the first stage.
Okay.
So, this is like 90% cooked dapat yung rice.
Malapit na.
Malapit na, no?
Nam.
So, nakakagat na.
No.
Tama yung taste?
Tama, oo. Oh, patis nga yung katapat. Tama pa.
Okay. More patis? Hindi na.
Hindi pa. Wala pa.
Wala.
I mean...
More? Hindi na.
Ah, naglagay ka na ng patis?
Yeah, kanina. Pero I can
konti
add more.
Lang.
Parang a little.
Yeah.
A little more. Oh, yan. Yan ang sinasabi ko eh. Wala tayong exact measurements. Nasa tikim, nasa konti na lang. So, for the second stage, you oil the leaves para hindi lang dumikit yung ganyan. And then you transfer the cook, bring it here. Low heat. Keep it there. In the meantime, can you help me place the topping, decorate?
I guess parang it kind of looks like a paella.
Exactly. Eh, alam mo yung paella natin in the Philippines? Diba kung ano-anong topping linalagay, including hard-boiled egg?
Mm-hmm.
Sa Spain, walang ganun.
Ah, walang ganun?
That's what I'm saying. Naging Pinoy na. Tapos tingnan mo, paano siyang naging paella yan?
Raisins?
Na raisins. It speaks of the fiesta, special occasion. Para bang gandahan mo siya na out of the ordinary, hindi yung pang-araw-araw.
I just want to be sure because I do not want to disrespect the dish.
Yes.
If ever I make Biringhi in the future, importante na may gata.
May gata na malagkit.
And malagkit.
Yes. With Biringhi, you have to follow yung steps.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you will not achieve the sticky rice cake.
Right.
This is the second stage. Ito, pinapa-in-in. And yeah. At the same time, you're caramelizing the outer, the bottom part. Yung usok.
Mm. Wow.
What smell can you...
Grabe, yung dahon.
Yung dahon mismo.
Saka yung mantika ng gata.
Ng gata, exactly. No, naririnig mo. Now pronounce yung sizzling. Oh.
Hindi, ganda ng tunog.
Oh, basically, this is the typical Kapampangan beringhi minus the quail egg. Yun na yung style ko as an artist.
Okay, okay.
So, the thing is, in Aray at Pampanga, kakaiba yung beringhi nila. You follow exactly the same procedure and recipe. Exactly the same ingredients. Kaya lang, presentation nila. What you see is a dome-like crust. I did that for you, Spliff. That. Kaya importante ito pa rin yung amoy pa rin. Hindi may pagkasuman na hindi mo alam, bibingka, suman, hindi.
Ganda ng caramelization.
Yeah. So, yun. Sa Pampanga, pag nag-attend ka ng fiesta, pag merong beringhi, sigurado yung main dish nila would be asadong manok or asadong babi, you know, the baboy. Ito yung palaging partner.
Mm-hmm.
So again, foreign influence, foreign name, but Pinoy.
Mm-hmm.
Pinoy na.
Mm-hmm.
And specifically, Kapampangan. Mm-hmm. Kami lang yata may asadong ganon.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. And brown. Wait.
Nice.
Mamaya pa.
Bango.
Ako na rin nga. Kumusta yung lasa?
Malinamnam.
Malinamnam.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's malinamnam without the MSG, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So you have the sokarat here, the tutong. Tama? Ah, there. You saw the process, how I did it.
Mm.
Walang shortcuts.
Right.
Everything so from scratch. Walang gimmickry.
Honest,
simple cooking.
Yeah.
Straightforward.
Minsan kasi, the most honest and simplest food is the best.
Exactly, yes.
And I feel like I had a long week and having this meal is like,
satisfying.
It's so satisfying.
You stick with the traditional, maybe your presentation lang mag-iba. So yung lasa nandun pa rin, the essence of the original, I mean the dish, in terms of like bringing, promoting it, explain it the way sisig was promoted.
Right.
We did not, the Americans, Bourdain especially,
uh-huh.
did not change the word.
Uh-huh.
It was sisig. Did not change the essence. Sisig as it is.
Parang laking tulong ka sa amin. And like laking tulong ka rin sa atin. So, yes. Salamat.
Para sa inang bayan. Para sa inang lutuin. Yes.
Cheers to
cheers,
bring it.
Cheers.
There are 4,000 Spanish words in Tagalog, such as baso, plato, cuchara, tinidor, langana, caldero, silla, la mesa, aparador, ventana, days of the week, months of the year, and so on. But like most things that are borrowed, some corruptions are inevitable, either in spelling, pronunciation, or even in meaning. Example, in Spanish, siempre means always. In Tagalog, it means, of course. Una vez in Spanish means one time. In Filipino, we say isang beses, which literally means one time. This idiomatic localization is no different from the culinary borrowings of the more popular Filipino dishes bearing Spanish names that are generally believed to have come from Madre España, like cocido, pochero, estofado, escabeche, caldereta, embutido, longaniza, lechon, ensaimada, and leche flan, to name a few. They may have Spanish names, but they definitely are Filipino in taste and aroma. Just how language and the meaning of words are ever evolving, I believe that food does the same thing. With everything I have learned from Chele and Cloud, I am now ready to work on my own beringhi recipe.
Super inspiring to see Cloud. Learned a lot from him. I mean, you know, as a young cook, I went to him. He taught me a lot, you know. He recognized me before. He was the first guy that gave me that validation, that gave me that confidence to push forward. And today, I once again was a student, learned the basics of how to properly cook beringhi. I guess when you want to, you know, put your spin to a certain dish, that's how you kind of
push our cuisine forward, but at the same time, within the boundaries of, yun nga, of like, kailangan nandun eh, nandun yung mga key ingredients eh. And also, flavor-wise, kailangan matitikman mo pa rin, malalasahan mo pa rin.
And since we are already in Pampanga, let's set up a nice camp spot to do it.
Sorry na sobrang tagal ng setup, pero worth it naman, right? Kasi it's all about the mood, right? Setting the mood, getting the right vibe, para rin masarap yung output natin. We came from Chele Gonzalez's kitchen, which is, syempre, OGN. At the same time, cloud, you know, history of Filipino cuisine. And right now, what we're doing is just we're continuing what they're doing. Because I believe that it's a collective effort, and that's why I got two of my friends. Tumatawa kayo dyan. Kasi hindi ko talaga magagawa to. I cannot do this without them, really. They're from here, they're from Pampanga. AJ, tagal na namin pinaplano to, tagal na namin gusto to. And then ito, si Chef Ron, taga rito, Kapampangan. And we are gonna make bringe. We'll try to be super respectful and honest with the dish. I'm just gonna use whatever I have or had in my freezer.
Onion muna. Turmeric natin.
Yeah. I guess yung difference dito is, yung kay Cloud na version, he was steeping the turmeric. What we're doing is we're sauteing.
Yeah. Para kabas yung flavor and ano, aroma na.
Tama. And at the same time, we're not in a normal kitchen.
Yeah.
We don't have a lot of water.
Pag medyo naamoy na natin, sulod na natin yung rice.
Okay. Ito, kunin ko yung rice.
Half enough lagi. Malagkit at saka parang regular rice.
Hello.
Growing up, usually every time na may feast sa amin, laging meron bringe. Yung mga lola namin, every time na uwi kami sa bahay na matanda, laging may luto silang ganito. Tapos, hanggang nakasanayan na tinuro nila kung paano gawin. Tapos may time na fiesta, kami na yung gumagawa for them. Yung ginawa namin base is yung classic na bringe recipe lang eh. Pero parang tatap namin ng mga isaw at saka...
I guess ito mga skewers natin. I guess we're just being resourceful. Kasi
kung anong meron lang.
We're adapting to our environment. Yung nakain ko last time kay Chef Chele na arroz caldoso, parang gitna siya ng paella and arroz caldo. May pagka-risotto na hindi. And eto, yung ginawa natin tatlo, para siyang kay Cloud na bringin na classic. Parang yun nga eh, I guess subconsciously parang nagawa natin yung dalawa sa isang plato. And na yun, I guess ako naman bilang Ilonggo, na-incorporate ko pa yung isaw. Pero hiniwalay ko. Kasi...
On the side lang.
On the side lang. Ayaw ko, kumbaga, why reinvent the wheel?
Yeah.
Grabe no? Daming kultura, daming personality, daming technique, daming influences. Pero nasama-sama natin sa isang plato. Together. On a plate.